So let's start with this. Just be with me. I'm sure something will come out of this. Yeah. Let's start with this quote. So the Carl Jung once said, a mood, emotion, attitude pattern goes through a community like a virus. Our current challenge is that an actual virus is combined with a collective emotional reactions, both occurring at the same time. So what is he trying to say? That there are two things, actual virus and the whole pandemic state which we have created right now. And that's what the virus loves it, you know, that whole pandemic state. What Jung was advocating is the conscious regulation of our response in order to decrease or at least not increase the growing wave of anxiety shared by the collective. You know how in this, with the technology, one news can reach all over, and the anxiety, even in the last village, is the same what the city is getting because of the media. Jung thought that those individuals with a stable mind serve as a breakwater against the tides of fear and anxiety. Now, this is where that one mind or the group of mind, when the collective healing energy can be created, in our world, can become a simulimum field. Yeah. So in this space, you know, I was making this art, and one of the art which I made was this, which I called fourth step. You know, many of you have attended my lecture and you are aware about the three steps of case taking, the three step of homeopathy, the three step of remedy reading, and three step of almost everything. Yeah, and the quote I gave here is, when an aware person is anchored at a home, he makes his home an inner home, center of his universe. Let me start with this story. When this kind of things, whether the bacterial or a viral infection or epidemic, was at its best, when the Sir Alexander Fleming, he found out penicillin, for which he got Nobel Prize. Do you think he was just a scientist, or he was a little scientist, but a more of an artist? And actually, like all good scientists, or he was both artist as well as scientist. Let's understand this part. And there's a reason behind why I'm saying all this thing. You may be thinking, why this in the beginning? But it's so much important to understand from where all understanding, whether understanding a pandemic or whether understanding a remedy, whether understanding an infection, whether understanding anything, a business or a science, needs art and science both. To understand our present pandemic, we need both the art and science in order to really understand. And this was the one of the reason. The first 2 months, I stopped WhatsApp. I stopped reading any news, stopped television. The whole idea was just connect with few, like WHO and president, vice president of WHO, and some modern medicine hospital which are working on this, and some holistic soul which really collectively thinking. Read 25 books on this issue, and then understood the pandemic aspect of it, the holistic aspect of it. And then gradually started talking to my close friends first, then the close teachers who are here, and then the other people. So let's first understand this Alexander Fleming. The Sir Fleming is best known for his Nobel Prize for penicillin, but he was also one of the first scientists to use microbes, bacteria, to create work of art, having created a series of gem paintings using living bacteria with a different pigment colors. What distinguished him from the other scientists was that he thought like an artist. He favored the method of artist over those of scientist. He loved bacteria so much that all his art began with bacteria. He would spend few hours in the morning in the laboratory, but whole evening till the late evening, he would spend in a Chelsea art club. He painted unusual medium depicting dancers, building battle scene and subject using bacteria. Like this, if you see, these are all live bacteria in a gelatin. What we use pencil, you know, marking, he put a gelatin there and then the bacteria would grow there, which he wanted. And he very well knew that each bacteria produce a color, something like this. These are all his paintings. And he must be the only one who loved bacteria so much, where all his paintings started with bacteria. Now imagine if you love something like this to such depth, naturally that bacteria or the bacteria problem will speak to you. And that's what happened. One fine day he was searching for one of his painting or one particular color. So he put in petri dish some bacteria to grow. And when he came back after a few days, he realized that it was actually the bacteria were dying. And then they found out the fungus grew, and then we all know what happened after that. And then the penicillin came out. Actually, he was searching a color, not answer to bacteria killing. Now that is where the whole issue. So when he did art and a science both together, the answer came to him. He collected bacteria for their artistic quality, while other scientists only collected what was useful or practical. When Fleming discovered penicillin, what he had really been looking for was something he could use in one of his paintings, something rare. Fleming spent his life searching for unusual and the processes that created them. In fact, to an extent, when he found penicillin, one day he decided that what will happen if I put my saliva in the petri dish, because saliva might also have a bacteria. And he was expecting that from saliva, some bacteria will grow. And then the bacteria started dying. He realized that in our body, there is a natural, in the saliva, there is a something called lysosomes, which are natural antibiotic. You remember when our grandmother used to say, when injury is there, put a saliva. He was the person who found out natural antibiotic in our body. Imagine, he's the one who found both out and inner antibiotic, but the research went only on outer side. This is where the problem happened. Anyway, what I'm trying to say, that art and science both is required in equal, even if we want to find out an answer to the today's problem. You know one thing, I was reading this all virus's book, I found out that 1% of virus, 1% of bacteria, 1% of plant, 1% of mineral, 1% of all natural resources, 1% of what you call the energies are poisonous to human being, only 1%. That means 99% of bacteria, viruses, plant are good. You know this one thing, that inside all our body, what we genes we have from our parents are just 12% now. 80% is virus and bacteria. In each cell of you, there are around 1200 bacteria and 100,000 viruses. That means they are so much useful to ourselves. Only some of them have gone crazy. So once we understand the concept well, we'll understand the treatment well. We'll understand the remedies well. We'll understand the advices well. So one is this. I spoke about. So inside our body, after talking about this, that inside our body there are two people. We know one which is learned, one which is intuitive. One which is right side, holistic, intuitive, abstract, and artistic. While other side, you see, there is this one which is a scientific, a logical, a left brain, you know, which is systematic. Problem happens when the artistic becomes too much artistic and scientists become too scientist. So we are like a holistic car with a two traveler inside. Both we need. The one which is a right brain who should be a driver, and the left brain should be a navigator. And even in the present problem, this should be there. Your answer to the problem should come from the artistic, holistic side. And then the left, who is knowledgeable, who is like a Google, who is like a Wikipedia, will guide you where to go, where to look, how to found. But answer has to come from the whole. So I always say that in holistic car, when it is driven by right brain driver and a left brain navigator, it's the best. That's my second point to you. Third point. We spoke about many time in many lectures for last 17 years about the three step of Gurdjieff, three step of universe of almost everything, three step of case taking. That initially we put anything we want to understand, homeopathy, case taking, present pandemic problem. We need to first put scientific effort, understand the science well. And that's what I did in order to understand this pandemic. Understand the science well. Initially, it would be scattered, not connected. One article from WHO, one article from China, one article from Iran, one article from Italy, one from America. Check what is going on. What is slowly you will see the connection between the pathology. Slowly you will see between the biochemistry, between the holistic level, what is going on in pandemic. And then gradually a pattern will emerge. Then match that pattern with when you understand the remedies, when you understand a treatment, when you give an advice to such kind of patient. So this was clear in my mind that this is what I want to do. So when you develop any theory of understanding or treating or preventing, advice should be based on integration of three steps, where the whole is at the driver's seat, where the individual and the whole is at the driver's seat, and the science is should be a navigator or a Google in a searching. Then, you know, the three step I derived from Gurdjieff, and the fourth step came from P.D. Ospensky, who was a student of Gurdjieff. I want to just tell you here a little bit about this too. The Gurdjieff was artistic, holistic, crazy, like a right brain is. Complete crazy at a whole level, intuitive level. And Ospensky was the science teach to the core. When we say the book Tertium Organum was written by him, the word organon came from there. He was so scientific, and they both matched well. Gurdjieff was abstract, couldn't express systematically, and he could. But they both fought because Gurdjieff was really crazy. And they both went away. And till the end, the Ospensky remained the scientific and the Gurdjieff remained the artistic or a holistic. They never met. And the idea was, imagine they both would have come together. That's where the fourth step would have come, where the science and art both beautifully coming together. Anyway, so the three steps of universe that determines the character of the nature of a health or a disease or a problem. And the law of seven determine how, whether this is disease or a health or a treatment, follow in a seven step. We know the seven levels of experience from Dr. Rajan and seven important of cardinal principle of seven in homeopathy, 7 days, seven chakra. We know this. Important, what I'm trying to say here is that whether it's a disease or a health, the main characteristic is decided by the three law, and then the seven laws helps how it develops. That's why I was trying to call that the whole, this lecture, let's call it a law of seven. What are those cardinal principles when you'll understand the pathology, when you understand the pandemic, what is going on? So let's start now. Now, till then, it was philosophy. Now, be with me. Now, your scientific mind, keep it active. The first thing I'm talking about is the seven things which are important in the present problem, what we call COVID-19. What I did is I first contacted WHO 2 months back, then contacted Harvard University students, amongst the medical MD students who come together with the other Chinese students and all, and they made a whole community of understanding COVID. Then contacted my friends, those who were dealing in Iran and the, you know, and in the Italy, and got the reports of the autopsy, 100 autopsy in Italy, 50 autopsy in China, and like that from America, to check the autopsy report so that we get exactly what is going on. So we are going there now. Keep your scientific mind active here now. Listen to me carefully. It will help you to really explain yourself to your patient, your friends, your relatives well. Yeah, let's start. So first I want to share with you the seven characteristics of a COVID-19 infection. Yeah. The first, that the viral entry. The virus entered from a type 2 pneumocyte. Yeah. In the body, whether from the nose, whether from the lung, and even some cells from the intestine. Now here, through a mechanism, it enters through a mechanism called ACE or a renin angiotensin mechanism. Virus protein interact with ACE2. Now what is it? It is a part of renin angiotensin aldosterone system, where it helps to convert angiotensin 2 into angiotensin 1 so that there is a vasodilator and not a vasoconstriction. Also, aldosterone is the one which regulate the salt mechanism, the fluid mechanism. Yeah. That's where it, the RAS is a hormone system that regulates blood pressure, fluid, and electrolyte balance, as well as systemic vascular assistance. So one part is this pathology. So we have to keep in mind the alveoli, the renin angiotensin system, the blood pressure, the cardiovascular system, and aldosterone system. One. Second, the immune response in the this kind of either a SARS infection or a, we had a Middle East respiratory syndrome, or now this COVID-2. Here, in a COVID-2, the important thing is the primary immune system, where we have this neutrophils, monocyte, macrophages. The the first, like your soldiers and not the king or the queen or the, you know, the important people, but the soldiers goes first and attack. What they call cytokine storm. But the secondary, which we need for antibodies, yeah, that's not there. Right now, they have not discovered. And I'm quoting in a green, if you see those people who have, whose articles have been approved. In COVID-19, the increase in the neutrophils in the lung associated with a severe disease. The higher serum pro-inflammatory response seen in the people with COVID-19 are associated with severity of the disease, suggesting that the cytokine storm is involved in a pathogenesis of severe disease. This is from, in the Lancet. But the adaptive immune response, which we need, like a B cell or a CD4 plus and CD8 and the T cells, this immune response is not yet been established in the, either in the animal model or the human. Now, this is one of the reason why we have such delay in the vaccine formation. Now, idea is that we have those primary defense inactive. So we need to put that into that antibodies are less. Third, when I checked all the post-mortem report, people who have done post-mortem in Italy, in France, in China, and some in America, they found that there is a pulmonary thrombosis, which is not typical acute respiratory distress syndrome. Now here, what happens is this COVID-19 protein stick to the hemoglobin, and it removes the oxygen. Once this hemoglobin is impaired, the red blood cell is essentially not functioning in carrying and delivering oxygen to any tissue. Also, they found the RBC become useless. Yeah? Because the virus is attached to their porphyrin. This leads to a destruction of a red blood cell and the patient's oxygen saturation levels drop significantly. And that what we see, the lung inflammation and the X-ray, which we see ground glass appearance, it's mimic CO2 poisoning or a carbon monoxide poisoning. What happening equate to the carbon monoxide poisoning, in which the carbon monoxide is bound to hemoglobin with the failure of gas exchange. So this also we need to keep in mind that there is a carbon monoxide poisoning. This is the reason we will find thrombocytosis and decreased blood oxygen saturation. Yeah. Next. Also, they found in a small village in northern Italy, where the majority of population suffer from thalassemia, there is no death or no cross-community spread. Even on the higher, like Nepal, you don't see the problem. So it says that it's not just the lung, but it's the blood problem. So we have to keep in mind the lung as well as blood problem. Because when we'll select remedies or group of remedies, after the individuality case has been taken, those group of remedies should kept in mind. Yeah, next point. Clinical presentation. We know that all, and I don't want to go in detail of that. We know the old age. We know the cardiac patient. We know the people with the COPD problem. They have higher at risk. Or people with the immune compromise. So that we know, I will not go into detail of that. Yeah. We know the common lab finding. Yeah.
Yeah.
So we'll not go into that right now, but yeah, lymphocytopenia, they have found out in 83% of the patient. So that also should keep in mind. Okay, so how they are treating in this way, we don't go into that. We all know that how, if it is a first stage where there is just dyspnea and, you know, and they measure, you know, take care at the home. We know all this thing, and now the measure is changing with the, now they realize it's not just the oxygen, but you need to give the plasma and the blood exchange, because what they discovered in the dead bodies. Anyway, other character, now this is the pathology characteristic. Now look from the other characteristic is elder patient. We know this. Decreased lymphocyte. Yeah. On the CT finding, we know ground glass appearance, which is not of a pneumonia, but it is because of the carbon, like a carbon monoxide poisoning. Another pandemic symptom we watch all over is exponential growth. Unstoppable pandemic, in spite of all measure we are taking. It's like a weed, you know, which is pandemic weed. Even if you try to cut it off everything, but it's still growing. Social distancing. Each one is locked up in their own little space, which is, again, we all know. Then a panic at all level. But most important thing is panic, especially on a relaxing mode. It's not a panic of our what we call solenesi kind of fright and flight reaction. But it is, you are in the home, but panic. You are, it created when you are on holidays, like China, they went to the Italy, or they went to the US, or they went to the France or the Spain. Means you are in a relaxing mode. You are in plane, you are at holidays, or you are at a prayer meeting. This is where its panic has been created. So panic is not because of the, what we call it, sympathetic activity, but it is when you are relaxing, the parasympathetic activity. That's the strange kind of panic where in holiday mode, you are getting this. Now, by keeping all this thing in mind, we go to homeopathic interview. Before going to the remedies, homeopathic interview. These are the 7 questions which helps me to talk to patients who are locked at home. I'm not talking about COVID patient only, which is not even a 1%, and not even a 1% of homeopaths are treating. The idea is all those other 99% and your own patient, they, because of this pandemic situation, they have got that state in them. An external state caused an impression on them. That needs to be understood. And then, of course, if you get a patient, some of us will get. Yeah? Let's understand. So we need to understand that this global present predominant pandemic situation has caused a state. So naturally, like an acute, we need to find out what is that present predominant pandemic state. Yeah. And since the state of everybody is disturbed, I'm sure along with that, you will get a constitutional state is also out. This is your best chance. For those 50% of patients of yours who are not doing well, and if they call you up, if they do video conferencing with you, just in this state, their whole state will come out. This is your best chance to do their cases. What question can be asked here? First, and this is what I use when I talk to my patient. Since this pandemic, what thought, feeling, fear, perception, imagination, nightmare, dreams, physical symptom you are experiencing, which you never experienced or increased since this lockdown, pandemic situation? Simple question like this to your patient daily will bring out all what they are going through. Second question. First illogical thought, first weird vision, first illogical fear when you heard about this illness for the first time. The first spontaneous vision which came in front of your eye when you first heard the word about this illness or this pandemic situation or a lockdown. I'm sure all of us got that thought or a fear. Why don't we just ask ourselves and our patient? Right now, if you exaggerate this illness or a lockdown or a post-lockdown stage to its worst, what picture comes up to you? And I've spoken to around more than 500 patients by now. Each one tells a different story. Each one, whether they've got it or their relative or just those who are locked up, it's a different story each one is talking. From film star to businessman to a common man. Idea is to keep those questions there. What kind of abstract feeling, emotion, thought comes up with this pandemic situation? When you keep this illness, situation, your diagnosis, tissue changes, pain, reports, all in front of your eyes, what abstract thought crosses your mind? Naturally, daily we are hearing on WhatsApp this kind of news. So, yeah, that abstract feeling, thought or emotion, which has no connection to this lockdown or illness, but comes up when you keep your illnesses in front of you. Message this present illness or situation gives you. What is the message that comes to you, or what message is caring for you or others? Most of the healers or most of the holistic mind healers, they are talking about that there is a beautiful message here. And I'm sure many are hearing to those and they have their own message. Ask them. That mind opened up the case. If this illness want to show you a key to yourself, what accounting to you is that key message for you? Naturally, if you know, everyone is spending that alone space with their alone situation. Each one will have some state, some message for them. Why don't we tap on that? What you think must be the experience of the people who are quarantined or hospitalized or isolated due to this illness? I'm sure each one has their own imagination. What if you are quarantined, hospitalized? What worst thought, image, feeling comes in your mind? I'm sure most of them are going through, what if it is me? Just bring it out. You have the whole individualistic and holistic state in front of you with this kind of questions. And that's what I do when I talk to my patient. When you see cases on a TV news, what about it touches you the most? Naturally, we all are going through that. Some news stays with us. For children, especially, you know, they can't talk, but they make their own imagination, their own stories. Why can't we tell them to just write once upon a time, long, long ago, with the situation this? Or draw what is coming up in your mind. Or write in your diary what comes up with this pandemic state. What can be done and what, you know, what you want to do with this state. I'm sure around 100 of children which I've spoken, each one draw differently, say something else. This way, they are also involved in that. Each one makes a beautiful, different poetry which speaks about their state. So like that, these are some questions, you know, which can help us to ask soon when the lockdown period would be over. 100 of them would come up because of this pandemic state on them. And out of those 100, not even a one may have the positive case. It's those which you need to handle now, who have, because of this pandemic situation, a damage has happened to them. What message this comes to you, or what message this carries for you? We spoke about this. Now, seven group of remedies which I suggest you should keep in your medicine kit. It's just a suggestion. After going through pathology, after going through the whole pandemic state, after going through the death body report, after going through the holistic listening to the patient all over, this is what comes up in my mind. Keep a note. See if it helps you. Yeah? The first is the prevention group. Then the acute group. In prevention group, I'm putting cinnamon, jasmine, Sambucus nigra. Yeah? Acute group, I'm putting up Culea, Saponaria, Echinacea, cinnamon, Sambucus nigra. All level group means if a people into pandemic fear and all the state-wise whole level coming up is Lobelia, Lobelia syphilitica, Bryonia, Euphorbia, Pilulifera. Just make note of this remedy. We are going there and why you will understand. Those people who have lung blood complication, I'm sure we are not going to handle these cases. Our government has not allowed us. If they do, well. But in many countries, they are handling. So when you talk to them, you see this can come up. Quercetraco. Grindalia, carbon monoxide. Then comes the health worker. I'm sure many of you are going and giving medicine to police officer or a health worker or a nurses or a ayabai or, you know, those people. This health worker, once this pandemic is over, they will be the one who are completely exhausted, either by illness or by the situation. So what comes up? Which group of remedies? Here is some remedies. It's like centauri, there's a back flower remedy, gentiales, which is the, you know, again, a gentianaceae remedy. Just make note of this. I'm telling you why. Then comes is the similimum story. When you're listening to your relative, your friends, what you can do to help them to create a similimum state. And then the other masters, what they have spoken about. The idea is we make our medicine knowledge more and more better. So when I'm listening to my patient with that individualistic feature and holistic feature, I may not miss out, which I don't know. And I only focus on few, which I've heard from people. Let's start why I'm saying one by one. Yeah? Culea saponaria. Now it is called soap bark tree. If you read Boric, it's mentioned most effective in beginning of the coryza. Dryness of the throat. That's one thing. But the modern research all point out towards antiviral activity. I went through the many researches on based on this remedy. Many point out to antiviral activities. What it does is including the interaction with the viral envelope leading to their destruction, with host cell membrane leading to a loss of virus binding sites and coating of the cell to prevent virus binding. And there are some more study down. Most of them, either the binding or the entry, it prevents. And different group of viruses. So, yeah, it can disrupt viral envelope and capsid protein at the concentration of 10-fold below cytotoxic level. And I've quoted also from where I've taken. So don't worry, everything what I've taken here in a green, you will see a quoted. Whether pathology I was talking, I've quoted those article which WHO has published and approved of, not from any other person, not even a doctor who's just given a video, from WHO approved article. So you can be very sure of when I'm talking this pathology and all. Cinnamon. Now, another remedy is cinnamon. We all know cinnamon, right? We use in our food. Now, why cinnamon? According to new research, the cinnamon has the high antiviral properties. One of the homeopathic remedies suggested by Dr. Rajan Shankar is camphora. Now, both belong to same group of the plant family. In fact, the camphor's scientific name is Cinnamomum camphora. So they are the cinnamon. So a new research. In 1917, when that Spanish flu happened, 50% of the patient received cinnamon tea, cinnamon powder, cinnamon in any form, because they felt it was best acting. Yeah, according to the Stanford University article, a popular remedy for the Spanish flu was cinnamon in powder or oil. Second. Third, in India, study based out in Pune, India, claimed that the cinnamon derived procyanidin polymer can turn HIV infected people into HIV controller. Now, by the way, the HIV group of virus also belong to the same group. Also, there's a Japanese study of for other virus, baculovirus. There's another study for herpes and cinnamon. So a lot about cinnamon and virus already. And we have cinnamon in our food. We can take cinnamon tea. Why can't we take this as one of the preventive thing just to increase our immunity? And it is there everywhere. It's blocking the entry. It's killing the virus envelope, the virus RNA. So it's win-win for us. So whether it is the leaf or whether it is the bark, both have the virus effect. Yeah, there's another study from the New York which says the cinnamon may contain antiviral properties in addition to its proven ability to regulate blood pressure. Now again, the virus as well as the blood pathology, which is the two main pathology of this right now pandemic. So it combines. Third, the cinnamon is potential angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitor. Now we were talking about that how virus take entry through angiotensin converting enzyme or the angiotensin 2. Now, if both are there in this group, don't you think this can be one of the remedy can be thought at least in our immunity improvement? And it is easily in every house in India, it has it. Why can't we suggest a cinnamon tea or a cinnamon, add cinnamon, whether when you take a ginger, lemon, garlic, or any ginger, lemon, honey, or anything, something like that. Yeah. In vitro study of a cinnamon as a natural inhibitor of angiotensin converting enzyme on a sheep tissues. So you see, I'm reading from every angle, from every pathology angle and checking. So if my medicine kit is there for future viral things, I will put this there. Next is our Cinnapis nigra, which is called elderberry. It boosts our immune system. It reduces the intensity and duration of a cold and flu. It gives large amount of vitamin C. And chemical of elderberry inhibits the early stage of infection by blocking the key viral proteins responsible for attaching and penetrating our cells. They also reduce the replication, therefore reducing the intensity and duration. So, and in a lot of European countries, they take elderberry as the immune boosting herb along with cinnamon. Yeah, it belongs to a family of a group called Dipsicales. Now, U.S. National Library of Medicine did a study of elderberry and a chicken who had been infected with the strain of coronavirus. Sowing elderberry was able to inhibit the coronavirus in the chicken. So why can't it is easily available? It's a, why don't we take as a, just as a, you know, to boost our immunity? Yeah. Also homeopathy wise, if you check, acts on respiratory organ, easily frighten, fright followed by suffocative attack. Imagine today that fright when the people develop cough. So both mental symptom is also there. Tendency to worry about tribal issues. So third remedy I suggest in the initial, you know, as a preventive. Now the group of remedy belong to Asteraceae, which we should have in our kit for any influenzal pathology or viral pathology, including this. Yeah. And that group is called Helianthe tribe in Asteraceae composite family, which some of you who did my plant workshop, you know. So I'll go a little faster here. That Ambrosia, Echinacea, Helianthus, and Vithia, four out of many here, I'm suggesting in your medicine kit. Why? If you read Echinacea, it is first word in Phatak Borik is acute autoinfection. Also a lot of inflammation, septicemia, and we know this. But what it does, the chemical inside is this. Has the ability to promote tissue regeneration and reduce inflammation. Also maintain the structure and integrity of the connective tissue and ground substance. There is a chemical hyaluron, which is a chief component of a connective tissue and of the ground substance, the intracellular cement that hold the body cell together. Now, when this is damaged, the bacteria or infection or antigen can enter into the body. That's why Echinacea, gargling, it is to prevent that entry. So that it heals those tissue and connective tissue where the entry becomes difficult. Yeah, one point. Now, research-wise, yeah. So I told you about the bacteria and virus can move if the hyaluronic acid is not there. Now, new research, pathophysiology. This remedy has demonstrated activity on macrophage. It does activation of polymorphonuclear leukocyte and natural killer cells. Now, why this is important? Because this is your first line of defense, which is get activated in this kind of infection. And remedy directly acting on the macrophage and the natural killer cell. What else you need right in the beginning? And strengthen your this army, which is your soldiers. So again, preventive or in a acute stage, or even people who have fear of that. New research have shown, as I told you, macrophages, that it act on macrophages, polymorphonuclear leukocytes and natural killer cell. That's why it can be, this is their words, prevention against treatment of various infections, upper respiratory or lower respiratory. Another thing is it act on also what they call the cannabis receptors to elevate your mood. And we know that one of the thing with this infection is the depression. So like this, the echinacea, whole the scientific research, what they have done, that it work on natural killer, yeah, it the maintain the your tissue level, inflammation, and all this, including anxiety and depression. So this can be one of the remedy where we can definitely people with infection and fear and anxiety and the depression. Yeah. Another group of remedy which I'm suggesting you should have is Lobelia group. You know our Indian tobacco, Lobelia inflata. And that group has many remedies, but three I'm suggesting: Lobelia inflata, Lobelia purpurans, and Lobelia syphilitica. You should have in your kit. Why? Now, the whole center of the family of this group is Campanulaceae. Yeah, the Campanulaceae master key is, there's a small trauma or a wound or an injury or an infection. Two, core vital part, root or central part or an organ, leads to sudden fear, panic, destruction, almost to the acute or a syphilitic level like Solanaceae. So a small cause affecting the vital organ or a root or center, leading to a panic where acute or a syphilitic reaction. Now this is exactly what is happening today in pandemic. But this sudden fear comes up. There is a fright and flight reaction, but with parasympathetic activity. What I mean by parasympathetic activity? In a relaxed state, holiday state, in a calm situation where you are not expecting, in your stramonium, belladonna, there you are expecting frightful situation. You are not expecting, you are relaxing and it comes up. So it makes sense, you know, that small cause affecting the center with panic, with relaxed state, like holiday mode, yeah? Now, the remedy Lobelia purpurans, which I know even if you read now, in a last webinar of Jeremy Share, he included this. Yeah? Farooq Master spoke about this. Why? Look at the remedy. The symptom come on with a great rapidity within 5 minutes of taking the drug. Respiratory paralysis, nervous prostration of influenza. Further, feel paralyzed as to heart and lungs. Deadly chill without shivering, useful for low nervous prostration of grippe. Grippe means the influenza, beginning of it. Superficial respiration, heart and lung feel paralyzed. So it's a lung remedy with total vitality lost, with lung and the heart involvement and the whole state. So I would definitely suggest that you should have this remedy with you. Lobelia syphilitica, also same, influenza, hay fever, but great operation in the lower part of the chest. Yeah. Another remedy I'm suggesting, this I have not spoken in my previous work, so you know, it's new for all of you. Euphorbia, from Euphorbiaceae. Euphorbia hirca, it is called. Now, why this remedy? Because the modern research has done a lot and they think this can be one of the remedy for pandemic, especially today situation. Why? A, you know, Euphorbia belong to a family, Euphorbiaceae, where the whole theme is you are locked in a small space and you can't move, free yourself. Like what is happening in this lockdown, you are in your limited space. Yeah. But what else about this remedy, Hirka? As I said, it is from U4BAC. It is called asthma plant. It is called sneeze weed. Yeah. In a Wikipedia, if you read, it's a pentropical weed. Now, why am I you saw the Asteraceae remedies are weed. This pandemic weed, which even if you want to stop, they don't stop. It's an excellent Ayurvedic medicine. It is regarded as the outstanding medication to treat respiratory disorder, including asthma, bronchitis, hay fever, and emphysema. The leaves are mixed with those of Datura, which is Solanaceae, Stramonium group, fear and fright, for preparing asthma cigarettes. So naturally, where asthma and the fear and fright. Further, hay fever, I told you. Dyspnea in cardiac disease, yes. In Australia, this is considered as one of the powerful medicine for asthma, especially in old people. Further, modern research wise, inhibits the activity of angiotensin converting enzyme by 90%. And it also, the second important research is its anti-dengue activity. And also the effect on HIV 1 and 2 and herpes. So excellent viral activity and the angiotensin converting enzyme, both together. Again, it is known as the asthma or a hay fever weed. So this remedy can be thought of with the lockdown state we are in, a limited space with all this thing. I remember one of the South doctor called me and she said, many patient I'm giving Croton Tig or the Euphorbia group of remedies because they all feel locked down. And if you see, Jeremy shared, he added one more remedy in fourth webinar of his as one of the remedy, Croton Tig, which is from the same group. So why can't we look from all the angle and keep these remedies with us? Another remedy, Green Dahlia. Now, why Green Dahlia? This is also suggested by Massimo, which he is giving in Italy, lot of patient. A, it acts on cardiopulmonary distribution of pneumogastric nerve. It raises blood pressure, act on pulmonary and weak heart. And Boger gives act on bronchioles, after which the alveoli start, the last part, not at the beginning of, big branches, the last part where the alveoli starts. So important. Also, it's an excellent remedy for old people with emphysema. And the mental symptom too, which are very important, longing for sunshine, light and company. On waking, room as if too small, feeling as if everything has stopped. This is what in the locked up state what we feel, and especially an old patient with asthma or this complication, and the fear is there in mind, not even the disease per se, but if the characteristic is matching, it can be an excellent remedy. Now another remedy, which is Quercus. We know this remedy in therapeutic wise for, which is called digitalis of a lung. Now, why? It has a chemical inside called aspidospermine, the whole, it belongs to a family called Apocynaceae, where your Apocynum, the vinca group. Now, all of them have cardiac glycoside inside. So it acts on the cardiac muscle. I'm not going in detail of that. The whole group has strength, endurance, and stamina, either step by step increase or decrease. And they stimulate their muscle, heart, lung, brain, and blood to the new level, almost like coca. And the opposite is exhaustion, as if a life would be extinguished. Now see the materia, what is written. Remove temporary obstruction to the oxidation of the blood by stimulating the respiratory center. It stimulates the respiratory center and increase the oxygen in the blood. Want of breath during exertion is the guiding symptom. As I told you, digitalis of the lung. Dr. Sarkar writes, it can be considered the homeopathic oxygen mask for the patient. Also, the aspidospermine reduces blood pressure, especially in patient with asthma or emphysema lung pathology. And Boric in big letter writes, thrombosis of a pulmonary artery. Now this is what the one of the leading cause of the death in this patient. That's why now they are thinking from the blood angle. Acute stage of thrombosis of a blood vessel of the lung. I think this is written by many thematic homeopaths. So thrombosis with lung pathology, with old, with increase the oxygen carrying capacity of the blood, which is reducing in this pathology. This can be one of the remedy, especially if you are handling at an hospital level. Yeah, I would suggest many today when I was talking to my Iranian friend and my Swiss friend, you know, with the, we are trying to create a lecture with WHO. So we were talking and they were also suggesting this remedy when I sent it to them that it makes sense. Okay, so aspidospermine, I'm not going into that. Carbon monoxide, one of the remedy we have. Yeah, now what carbon monoxide poisoning does is, low level of carbon monoxide poisoning symptom, a flu-like symptom. Now when you poisoning is there, flu-like symptom, shortness of breath, unexplained panic, anxiety, and sense of dread. And extreme poisoning can cause collapse, seriously low blood pressure, heart and respiratory failure. So very important, you see, even in the poisoning, this is what is happening. And now the scientists, the research who are doing, the paper which got published and approved, they are saying that this pathology matches exactly like carbon monoxide poisoning. And the lung appearance is because of that, where the, yeah. So you can keep this also with you if you are handling cases at a hospital level. Yeah. Now the some remedy after COVID infection or after this pandemic state is over, especially with the people who, due to the anxiety and the whole state got exhausted, or the health worker, or the caretakers, or the people who are taking care of these people, or the people around, when they will get exhausted. So this group of remedies, one of them is our Swarchia Chirata, which is also called Indian China. They all belong to the same group of China. And some of them, like Gentia Lutea, is 260 times more bitter than China. In fact, what is China was to Europe, the Swartia Chirata is for the India. It is called Indian China. Same for malaria, same bitter in taste, same experience. See, what is this group has a center? The whole center of Gentian EAC is they need stimulation, especially when they are exhausted, burnt out in chronic disease, debility, chronic ache, convalescence, long serious debilitating state. When their health has gone much below the normal level of strength, stamina, or vitality. Debilitating, devitalized, below normal stage of health, stamina, system, body, or mind, completely burnt out. Now, this is what we will see in this kind of police, whether police officer or nurse or sisters or doctors or people around, health workers basically. And one of the remedy, which is this bark flower, is Centaurium erythrea. Why? Because the center of this remedy is you get exhausted by serving others. Yeah? You need stimulation, and where you are exhausted and you want to come back to normal level of strength or stamina or vitality from serving others, taking care of people with chronic or this kind of pandemic state. So I would definitely suggest this. And other, this Gentiana and Gentiana lutea, they are in allopathy used as tonic. In fact, most of the allopathic tonic are made from this. So why can't we keep in our, if the center state is matching, these remedies? Okay, I'm not going in detail. So these are the some of the remedies I'm suggesting. And these are the some of these remedies which other masters have suggested. Keep a knowledge about them. Especially Jeremy Sher, he's doing every week one workshop to upgrade himself, whatever 1,000+ cases he has, he shares with us, and whatever new he's learning. I'm sure Dr. Rajan is doing a lot from his side. Massimo is doing in Italy a lot of cases. So like that, many of people, we don't have still that much cases to treat, but a lot of people abroad, they are handling it. We are helping them. So keep in mind that these are the remedies. Keep in your, in future, this state won't go. And because of this pandemic, the state would get more aggravated. People will get more influenza, more flu, because the immunity going down, it will help you. Yeah. Now, some of the suggestions from like a sum to increase immunity, you can have jasmine tea. Now, why jasmine tea? Because again, the research wise, jasmine has been shown antiviral and antibacterial activity at a big level. Cinnamon tea, I spoke about that in detail. Elderberry tea, I spoke about it. Yeah. So this is the whole idea, that take a case in detail, keep this kit in a mind where the state is matching, select one of them. Yeah. Now further, anyone has any question here? Should they be used as a tincture or a posology? Keep with you. See where the state is matching. Idea is let the state should match. Yeah, this is not on pathophysiology only. I'm showing you remedies from pathophysiology, remedies from whole pandemic fear, remedy at a lung level, at a blood level, so that what you see and what fear comes up in the normal patient, you can think about this. Keep this as your kit. I'm not suggesting anything else but to keep it as a kit. Like cinnamon, elderberry, jasmine, suggest them when patient call to you that take this will increase your immunity for sure, because the research has been done on this. Like that, rather than suggesting anything where the research has been beautifully proved and seen. That's the idea. Anybody else? Now, Sonal Mistry is writing, because a well-selected simile also act fast and has a strong, this remedy is acting on. No, it's a well-selected remedy. Imagine if you have taken a case. That's why I started with case taking. And where the individual features and holistic feature, individual, I mean the part as well as whole, is matching. And you keep these remedies in mind in your repertory. If one of them comes, if let's say croton like comes, think of euphorbium in your mind, because otherwise you will miss them. Dr. Anand Joshi is right. Also including a Dr. Anand Joshi, I missed it. Remedies in the present and acute for next few months would make us explore such untouched remedies. Exact, you will get more and more of such acutes now, because a pandemic stage leaving an impression will remain for some time. See where it is coming up. Never to go with one. That's the reason why I studied from everyone. From lots of books. Listen, if I'm saying pathophysiology and everything I'm checking, a lot of research has been gone on this. And I don't want to suggest a remedy to you. What I want to suggest that you should have a kit. You should have a case taking, and we go further. You should have an advice to your patient, because 99% of your patient would be those patients which don't have COVID, which don't have, but the fear psychosis has entered into their mind. That's where our role will come into picture. Some of us, like me, Jeremy, and we got an opportunity to talk to Italian friends, Iranian friends, American friends, and we are helping them. Lot of us will not get that opportunity. There, it's one-to-one patient. Yeah, anyone else? Further. Now, after saying this, I want to tell you something further. That some books you must read. You have a good free time. Let's not only talk about this infection and gets burnt out. Most of us will burnt out by the information what we are getting from the people. I would advise, the first thing I did for 2 months is read 25 books related to lockdown, related to viruses. Some I'm suggesting, like A Planet of Viruses, that how this book speaks about the viruses are not that bad the way we are thinking. Very good book, I feel. Then another big book by Sonia Sharp, Pandemic. Very good book. A Hot Zone, it is about Ebola, very well research done on Ebola epidemic. But when you remove the Ebola, a lot of other things are very helpful to understand the pandemic concept or holistic concept of a virus. Then most of your patient will call you with this locked up period, how bored they are and what is going on. They need to go out. You can explain them the boredom. And by the book, you know, bored and the brilliance, that how this bored state, the being in your space, is the best gift one can have. Then there's another book, Genius Life, Heal Your Mind, Strengthen Your Body and Becomes Extraordinary. I feel we being an homeopath and we deal with immunity, we should know immunity well. The two book here I'm suggesting, Immunity by William E. Paul, and The Super Immunity by Joel Fairman, which is all about, the super immunity is all about which food can increase our immunity. And the first one is general immunity to the basic level, where to understand from the primary immunity to secondary immunity to exactly what's happening. You will understand, in fact, a much better way what is happening in human body. Yeah? And then there is a book called This Is a Chance, The Shaking of an All-American City, A Voice That Held It Together. There was a calamity, but if when you remove that calamity out, but the answer is the same. You know what will happen with this calamity, what we are facing? Yeah? So like this, you know, read a peripheral thing also so you understand it better. Another thing very important in such situation is soon our the lockdown period would be over, or Still, for 6 months, the partial lockdown will go on, as I understand it correct. Naturally, being in this home space, I need to have a balance. I or your patient, we all need to have a balance in a personal and a professional field. What I suggest here is the daily divide 6 to 7 hours of professional work. Daily 3 to 4 hours of personal or household work. Daily 1 to 2 hour of a right brain alone space. Right brain artistic activity. 1 hour of learning something new. Now this will keep you balanced between both the side of you. A professional and the personal side. A professional and the artistic side. Many people are doing too much of artwork only in this space. Or many people working more than required. 1 hour of physical exercise, 8 to 10 hours of sleep. I'll suggest you 2 or 3 books on sleep, which is amazing, and you must have that. It's so much research has been done that how 8 to 10 hours sleep is must. Anyway, so like this. Then in daily, your alone space, you know, the space which has been created, write what you are learning is, whether about this pandemic, whether when patient is talking to you, whether something new from the book. And as you talk to one by one patient and you listen to the fear of patient of different age, different situation, you will understand a wholeness, what is going on. It will be easy for you to guide them. I personally feel that you should write. This is the best time to write down daily what you are learning from your patient, from the books, from this your space, from this psychosis, what, you know, pandemic fear psychosis, what has been created. Daily talk to one or two patient or a one or two relative. Listen just of what question I've told you. And see what comes up on the surface. Let the whole state come out. And with many of them, I am convinced you will not be able to give simulimum due to lockdown. They are far away. But you can create something. I give you an example. I don't want to name one of the film star called up. Of course, many... He's there on the television of guiding us what needs to be done in this lockdown period. But inside, we are all human beings. So he also has his own fear and panic. I spoke to him in the morning, said, just describe what's going on. He said, I'm giving interviews. I'm on this. But inside me, what if my children, my mother gets, my parents gets it? What if I get it? I'm into such business. And then he explained that slowly I can see the whole world is going to, it's disintegrating. I can see it, it's happening. The business is going, the relations are going, everything will disintegrate. It's like, it's a mass destruction which is going to come now. And I'm panicking because of this. Anyway, then he went on and on about the disintegration and panic. We spoke for half an hour, 45 minutes. Of course, I could not give him a medicine at that time because he had to send with a car and a police and all to get it. But meanwhile, I told him a story. I said, yeah, because I'm talking to many people all over the world. I recently spoken to one person from Hollywood and I named him, which he knows. And the story was exact the same. Exact same, but I intensified. Now, see what I'm doing. His story is this. I'm giving him another story from another country, but little stronger. What is this? Don't you think it's your aphorism number 26? When two similar come together, what happens? We read it, but we don't apply. Why don't we listen to people and the story which they are saying, give another story similar to them if you can't help them with a remedy or something. That itself calms them down. And that's what happened with him. He again gave a beautiful interview and what was required by him. And anxiety went away. Like that, many examples I can give you. But idea is daily listen to one or two patients. This is what you can do. Or one relative. Or those 30 to 40% of your patients who are not doing well. This is where your role will come into picture. Listen to them intensely. Bring the whole state out. Either give a similar one which amongst them, if it is coming up, or anything new which you are sure of. Or give a story. An example, maybe from China, from Italy, from your country, wherever. It will make a huge difference. The principle will work there. And second, the professional and personal coming together in your this space, it would be a real vacation. I am totally convinced. After this, I will show you what I did for every 7 days. But before going into that, I will ask some of my colleagues what they are doing in this space. Listen to them. Just 1 minute each one to speak and see what comes up. Maybe Harpreet, if you can start your mic and share.
So in the beginning, what I did was the moment lockdown was announced. So initially, I was happy that I got a break from my profession and everything. And I will be now in my own space. But somehow, I got in contact with many patients who were having anxieties about that, about their businesses going down, about their health is going down, what will they do in the future. So I was just going around all those things. And what I came to was I found out a few quotes which I would like to share. One of them was, there was one story that was worrying about things beyond your control is a pretty good formula for illness. Mm-hmm. I was saying all of them that if you worry, it will bring down your health. If you more worry, it will again bring down your health. You will get diseased. But while doing all these things, I came to another quote, and that was like this. Mm-hmm. So it was like, the more something upsets you, the more it is meant for you. So when it is no longer upsets you, it is no longer needed because the lesson is complete. So at this moment, I thought that if something is happening to somebody, it is needed in the moment. Mm-hmm. So this is what I studied. So these were two contrast things that I get to know. So maybe it was different things, two different perceptions from everybody. So I was just thinking about all these things. And few days back, something dawned on me, and I came up with a new idea that this was it. That everything that happens for a reason. And when it happened, rather than worrying about it, you should focus on it. We should accept it, experience it, and give our full potential to it. And then we will move forward. So that is the idea, that we should accept everything without any worry. We should focus everything that is happening around us. Only then the creativity would come from us. And then our full potential will be shown to other person, and then it is the only way how we can evolve, as given in the 9th aphorism by Hanuman. So this is what all I did. Thank you, sir.
Lovely, lovely, Harpreet. This is important. Rather than just talking about the problem, how creatively we all are sharing. This is where we all need to, like what I did in the world is, I suggested all my close friends who are artists that create a platform of the art and keep sharing. And they made a whole world art which came up only in COVID, and they created a platform. It's such a beautiful thing to spread such thing. Anyway, Yogesh, you would like to speak? I'm just telling one minute to each one of them just to check, see what each one of them are doing.
I'm audible, sir, now?
Yeah, you're audible, Yogesh. Go ahead.
Sir, I'm reading one book, Alchemist. I found one line that the men have to go away in order to return. Mm-hmm. feel like that the same thing is happening with us. If I give my example, I am too much in my professional life. So, most of the time, something your experience tell that no, you are doing something, you are stretching yourself in one direction too much. But in this condition, in COVID condition, we all are, if I speak my personally, this realization comes because of, not because of the awareness, but it is without the choice. As the lockdown leave me with no choice rather than to stay home. So, as because I'm not doing this previously, because I'm too much stretching in my professional space. So soon I realize, the first I get disturbed by this idea that sitting all the time sitting at home. But soon I, when I'm spending professional time with the family, playing games with the kid, wife and friends, that bring back some balancer. And surprisingly, it increase my productivity too. So my short message, this is my message for everyone, that bring balance between all the area of your life. Enjoy every area and don't stretch yourself too much in any dimension, including study or playing or anything. Keep balance. This is what I find, sir.
Lovely, dear. So that's what you found, the balance at the home space was missing, and that's what you got. And then you could do to both the side well, right? Lovely. Can I ask Reena?
Hi, sir. Hi. Am I audible?
You are audible, yes. You want video?
No, sir. Fine.
Go ahead. Just, yeah.
Yeah. Thank you, sir, for the opportunity. Every year, I always go to the Himalayas in the spring. It's like how a bird awaits sunrise. Mm-hmm. And since 3 years, I have been going all the time, increasing my time span. Mm-hmm. And this year, actually, I had taken a one-way ticket and I had decided I will return only when my heart speaks mm-hmm. that I should come back. So I already started preparing my practice online. Mm-hmm. But as Corona struck, and it struck very hard, and first 2 weeks were very extremely difficult for me to pass because I was churning between hopeful and hopelessness, whether I will be able to hike or no. Mm-hmm. So I started talking to my friends and my teachers, and it helped a lot. Mm-hmm. And a slow letting go happened, and naturally my attention shifted to reading, which mm-hmm. is very dear to me. Mm-hmm. And I like reading history. So I mm-hmm. began to read Sophie's World, Sapiens, History of Coffee, Sea of mm-hmm. Poppies, mm-hmm. and many other books. And I thought a new travel journey has unfolded, and I started writing a lot of poems. Mm-hmm. So I wrote one for today, mm-hmm. which is called Imagination, mm-hmm. Inner and Historical. So I will just read the poem. It is about, picked up my understanding from these different books which mm-hmm. talk about history. Mm-hmm. So here it goes. The poem is like this. I want to climb the mountains and flee. For what? And imagine freedom maybe. Mm-hmm. But the cosmos changed the destiny. For humanity, plan cannot be. And we think about a cup of coffee, but it is not European nor Belgium. It is Yemeni, used for a deeper search by a Sufi. A band of foragers were we, but how come became settled in currency? We thought it to be revolutionary, but the biggest deception was this imagined treaty. The wheat, a simple grass, domesticated humanity. And from a moving tribe, we became stationary. Then arose civilization, wars, enemies, imperialism, and colony. From a single grass of wheat, you see. And then came script to store the wheat, the barter, the coins, and cowrie. And to make it all easy, printed man and put trust in paper become monetary. Well, the rest is your story. This time, I climbed the mountain of world history, sitting in my room, traveling with my mental faculty. Gradually came clarity. You are the still center of the life wheel, which is always motionary. And that is where I want you always on the verge, said Rumi. Thank you, sir.
Lovely, dear. So this is the whole idea, that how initially it struck of your desire to walk on Himalaya, which you do every year. And then how you settled and understood the meaning of it, and then the poetries. Lovely, lovely, dear. Can I ask Dr. Shailesh to speak from Madhya Pradesh? I'm giving you mic, Shailesh, 1 minute. Yeah, Shailesh.
Yes, sir.
You need video?
No, sir.
Go ahead.
So it took 3-4 days to accept and understand all this situation. Then I decided I will use this time to reboot myself. So I divided my day for different works. Some time for household work, some time to study homeopathy and different books, and some time for entertainment like ghazals and movies and web series. This brought the needed balance to my routine. Then when it comes to my hobbies, driving is my first love. But it was the first thing that I was unable to do in this period. Then photography comes to me. But there also the choice was limited, because I was in a limited area. Then I thought, why don't I apply individualization at the holistic level here too, and see what come up. So I started, I clicked same object with two dimensions. One whole view with macro or broad lens, and another part view with micro lens. And what I found, they both were unique. They both were different. I clicked each and every corner of my house, including in apart from this, insects, plants, flowers, birds. I clicked so many photographs. And in this time, one thing I learned about photography in this period is you don't need big camera, higher lenses, or a scenic view. One thing needed is a deeper holistic as well as individualistic vision. It's your vision that makes a picture perfect. Thank you. Yeah.
Can I ask Vaibhav to speak? Yeah, Vaibhav, go ahead. You need video?
No, sir.
Go ahead.
Sir, basically...
Vaibhav is from the Indore, like Dr. Shailesh. Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, in this lockdown, I have explored my creative self, basically. And I feel a lot of peace inside. This whole period was like a still moment for me, where I can peacefully do all my artistic activities, and I have made many crafts which come from my intuitive alone self, and I'm knowing myself more these days. So after making some artwork, I understood that more idea of my most craft things were some that was related to nature. Mostly I connected with water bodies, fountains, and greenery. So whenever I felt that this is my semi-liminal field which heals me, and maybe it gives me semi-liminal healing energy to progress, to feel better, and like that. So yeah, it was a great experience overall. Many inner core experience I had, and they were healing experience, so enjoying, and also importantly learning from that, sir.
Lovely, lovely, dear.
Understood this concept only from you, sir, and I am very thankful to you from my bottom of my heart. That is a whole concept of creating simulimum and understanding it through nature and creative things, understood only because of you, sir. Thank you
lovely,
so much.
Lovely, lovely. See, idea is to share, and I would love tell people to just wait for 15-20 minutes more. I know you might have some other thing to do or other webinar. Just wait, something beautiful will come up to understand the how each one of them, and finally I share what beautifully happened. Yeah? And to what best we can do in this space. Can I ask Dr. Riddhi to speak?
Hello?
Yeah, go ahead, Riddhi.
Yeah, hello everybody. Basically, I'm with Dr. Dinesh now since last 8 years. And this lockdown period is completely opposite state of my life, which I had been for last so many years. Because I, as an individual, used to work 6 days a week at his clinic and had no inclination to spend my time at home at all, which was my last option. But now with the lockdown, it is... I knew I had no option. So what I started doing is I started creating change in small areas of my life at home. And whether it is cooking with my mother-in-law, I'm learning all the biocycling recipes from her old culture, to creating art space for myself where I'm putting homeopathic thoughts and philosophy of life together. Or I have a small daughter with me, so I'm spending time with her, creating new activities every day, like making dolls, making mud toys, planting seeds, redesigning her clothes. So basically, such small changes also is making a huge difference in my thinking, in my learnings, and giving me good energy space in this lockdown period too. So, and
lovely. This is so what you learned about that, how the professional and a personal home space, and handling being a homeopath and then handling the baby, where how best balance can come up in this lockdown period, huh?
Yes. And it's surprising that I had read this book, When Everything Changes, Change Everything. You know, this is a book which I had read 6 years back, and now I can relate to that beautiful concept, that how it can bring a balance.
I remember this book, and I would really suggest this book, When Everything's Change Everything. Beautiful book, I believe. You can send the name of the author and all here.
Sure.
Dr. Ranga Rajan, can I ask you to speak? Dr. Ranga, he is from the South India, from the Davangiri. Yeah, Dr. Ranga.
Yeah, sir. Thank you. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Go ahead. Little louder and yeah, go ahead.
I'm so much passionate stories. Mm-hmm. So first few days of lockdown, I was going to my clinic. I was looking this lockdown road, empty roads. I felt I am in some story, like childhood stories. Even my grandmother used to say, don't go out, that some ghost will come and eat you and police may arrest you. Mm-hmm. So that's what become reality in this lockdown times, I feel. So, and when this physicality of ours is limited, but the mind is not limited, our stories are not limited. Mm-hmm. We can travel from past to present in these stories. Mm-hmm. So in this lockdown times, I was listening more and more stories on YouTube, many Tamil stories, Tamil literature stories. Mm-hmm. So I continuously listening these stories. Each story was like bringing some awareness to me. Some stories touched my heart. Some stories resembling my character or my some wounded part. Each story gave a different perception to my life. I think we all homeopaths are habituated to listening stories daily. The first thing when lockdown happened, we could not see patients. That made me restless is that I could not listen stories from patients, because I feel like daily we listen stories and we give stories to them in the form of medicine. And each story, we intensify the story and we give it to them, as SARS did to some Bollywood actor. I think so. First thing happened in my lockdown days was I was restless. So I turned into listening stories, a wonderful stories in which I never imagined changed my life all this time. So I feel all should listen stories more and create your own stories and let the lockdown stories continue. Thank you, sir.
Lovely, Ranga, lovely. And this is coming up from where the Dr. Ranga Rajan is spending 1 year of his lockdown period with Hahnemann. So he's locked down with Hahnemann and he's trying to understand word by word of Hahnemann and understand the concept. And the other side, look, the man is talking about the story. So it's so important. Just 1 minute, give me, my battery is going. That look, a man who is pursuing Hahnemann with such passion, also talking about story. This is where the both side, the art and science side, should come. This is where it would make a difference to all of us. When we are only at one side, we will miss it. Like in my new book, A Right Brain Approach, this is the whole idea. Maybe some other day we talk about that, but the idea is when you have a story, that story can become a simile. And that's best if you match it sometime when you're listening and you are being can become for them a good, their whole anxiety of pandemic can go away. Thank you, Ranga, for this. Can I ask Dr. Urvi?
Okay, so this lockdown, for me, well, as I mean, I've always been a person who have been working from home most of the times to balance my other responsibility, and especially of my motherhood responsibility with the professional life. This was a beautiful time for me to share more space with my daughter. And she is growing, and now she is almost entered preteen age. And it has been a beautiful experience for me to experience that girl, that child turning, who has already turned into the girl, which otherwise, you know, I was so busy in my life that I never realized. And now this girl and me, we are finding a beautiful bond to spend time with each other. And I've always been into this wholesome food and helping myself, helping the family and my patients. And this was the time where I could involve my daughter into this recipes that I've been creating. And there were times where we were not having, the vegetables were not available. And whatever we had was available with us, we had to really think creatively to do something about that. And this concept of bio-upcycling thing has always been something that I passionately get drawn towards. So this was the time where I could involve my child with, creating new recipes. And I was so happy to see her involved so beautifully with me. And the girl is, so what I've learned is, you know, that how my bonding with my daughter has increased because of the time that I'm able to give her. At the same time, I'm able to do my work. So this was one thing that I've, experienced. And this has also been like an opportunity for me to, upcycle things in a way where my daughter got involved, and we created recipes out of watermelon skin. We created diaries out of old school paper, paper of the of her school notebooks and her old worn out clothes. We created biodegradable detergents which can be used for as a floor cleaner. The seeds that we got in our house when we ate papaya or we ate muskmelon, we created microgreens out of those. And this is a time where I got nostalgic about this composting that I've been doing for past few years. And last year in my compost bins, there were a lot of mango seeds that came out as a sapling, and that was gifted to few people. And this is Dr. Sailesh. So this was gifted to him last year, and he sends me this photograph this year. So this is the baby sepal who has grown to this height. And again, we are back to that mango season where new saplings will be getting ready. So this has been a time where I've been able to engage more creatively to this concept of bio upcycling and recycling, and also witnessing my daughter joyfully joining me. So this has been my experience of this COVID lockdown so far. Thank you.
Now, since I'm audible, Atul, you would like to speak? Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, Atul, go ahead.
Yeah, so basically, since the lockdown started, I obviously knew that we are going to be with it for some time. It's not going to end very soon. Mm-hmm. And I generally have a tendency to go out for exercise first thing in the morning. Mm-hmm. So since the time this lockdown has started, I realized one thing, that I will not be able to go out for the exercise that I do. So I started thinking, what can be the other ways of, achieving what I want to. Mm-hmm. because if I don't exercise, I realize that I start having my aches and pains back in the body. And before the lockdown, if you think of a normal routine life, I have always been, you know, living in a way where I exercise and I then go to work. And then most part of the day goes in work, when generally we tend to ignore the exercise, pains and aches in the body, and we just sort of let the day pass casually. But with the lockdown, what I've tried to do is I have tried to bring all the fragmented parts together by trying to find the right kind of exercise, which will help me stay fit, which will help me reduce the aches and pains that are there in the body in the lockdown space. At the same time, something that will also help me to join all my fragmented thoughts together when I am doing the physical exercise. So since the time I started practicing that, after maybe 5 to 7 days, 10 days, I started realizing that I'm getting closer to the movement in my body that is giving me the exact kind of peace and calmness which I was looking for, which I'm sure I will continue to do once I'm out from this lockdown, so that I don't any further lead a physical and a mental fragmented life.
Lovely, lovely.
Chandrasekhar, you want to speak?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, go ahead, dear.
Yes, sir. Basically, I'm a very restless person. People around me also complain that I'm not in one place. Many friends and dear ones. And this lockdown was there, for a moment, I felt it's good for me that I am in one place. But soon I realized it is not just that physical lockdown is the thing. I really started struggle to connect to myself. That was a real struggle for me. How to go about. I indeed spoke a word or two about this with you also, I guess, sir. This has been a real struggle point to connect to myself. I regret that I'm not utilizing this in a proper way. Then slowly, I realized ki it is not just the physical staying in one being is important, but how to. It is to connect to ourselves. That is more. It was more struggling for me, and gradually I've started doing that. Wo thehrawana bahut zaruri tha andar se. That slowing down from inside was the biggest challenge, and gradually I am getting that. And once this started happening, then. There is something, we speak about a lot of right brain activity, stimulating our right brain. And I realized it is not from outside which happens. That thing is there already inside. Like once I had asked you also, sir, ki ye mujhe kab aayega right brain? I am very much logical man. So then I remember that answer a couple of years back, you said, aayega, ek din aayega beta. Then it just happened that the other day ki I was just sitting down and out. I was just lying down. Then I started, then I saw just a paint on a fan. It was seemingly like a Hulk. Means a picture. It was just a paint scrape. But I could see that Hulk in that picture. And gradually these images I could see around something or the other, which was my usual day-to-day this thing. Then I realized ki it was actually there since my childhood, but somehow I had lost it. And then this slowing down from inside actually started happening, then this thing has come up, which was lost long back, I guess, maybe especially for the last 4 or 5 years. So now I'm really understanding the purpose of it, why that struggle was there, and really means to connect to myself, so that makes some sense for me at the end of the day, that
that I could connect to myself and see that stimulus of the lost art within me. Like in childhood, I could see or see pictures in the clouds. Like till now, I see a map of Karnataka in moon. Every time I see the moon, which I had lost it.
So such kind of childhood activities which comes back, and it also helps you to do your scientific work very well.
Yes.
Balanced.
Yes. Somehow I got that lost art.
Exactly.
Which was there.
Lovely. Dr. Sukhdev, you want to speak?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead. Keep it short in 1 minute. Yeah, go ahead.
Good evening, everyone. And thank you, sir, for giving me this opportunity to speak. Actually, lockdown period was very hard initially because I'm probably a multitasking person.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm doing college, clinic, and visits. And somewhere I busy in those external world, and this lockdown given me the time and space. Mm-hmm. And in the initial few days, I was doing nothing. And suddenly I realized doing nothing is the best part of life. Sometimes you did not do anything, just lie down.
Mm-hmm.
And just empty yourself, because I realized that if I want to receive something new, I have to empty the world.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes inside, then I can embrace two and make it one.
Mm-hmm.
So then when I was doing nothing, then I started realizing I was playing music at my childhood. I get back that I was playing carom, like I was re-enjoying my childhood, because family was not there with me there at their place. So I was alone. And this has given me the clear idea what to do in next period. Because doing many things can lead to confusion. But when I'm empty, I got a time, I got a inner empty space. Now I want to fill with something what I want to do. So I got the focus.
Lovely. Yes.
So that's what I want, got the focus, and I'm working on it. And I'll just keep in touch with you and I'll send you.
Sure. Michael, you would like to speak? Yeah, go ahead, Michael. He's from South India. Go ahead.
Hi, sir. Can you able to hear me, sir?
Yes, go ahead.
So this space taught me to balance, how to balance out both sides, sir, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Especially my professional space and my home space. Because I was out of my home for past 10 years for my studies and practice and staying in different place actually for more than 10 years. But mostly once I'm coming, but I was out of this home routine phase and everything.
Mm-hmm.
So because this home space, this professional space, this side is very routine for me, and it's usual side, or it is adapted by us, it is like comfortable. Another time when I come up to home, and I was after 10 years and spending a long time here actually.
Mm-hmm.
This is initially it was strange, or it is maybe some opposite or something different from the routine. So I can't able to do anything. So then I restart myself actually. I go back to, because I can't able to go further in both the sides. Then I restart myself that to how I am before this 10 years, how I started my professional side, and my how I was in my home space. Then start slowly, one by one, everything comes. So slowly I accepting which is coming in this both side, and I was realized what I'm seeing in the both side which is me. Then I able to manage both the thing. I'm for the patient also, I'm talking. I'm talking to some students also, and in home also I can able to enter. So in short, I can able to manage the both sides.
Lovely. So you are working somewhere in a beautiful that Manitham homeopathic hospital, but now you are in Kanyakumari, and how both balance, where earlier you were staying there and helping 24/7 the developing that hospital and teaching homeopathic students. But now you are balancing from home place very beautifully and guiding students and the patient.
Yes, sir.
Lovely, dear, lovely. Dr. Srinivas, you want to speak? Yes, Dr. Srinivas, go ahead.
Good morning, doctor.
Go ahead. Yes.
I actually am not a doctor. I am a practitioner, I mean, of yoga and naturopathy.
Lovely.
Also a government servant by profession.
Uh-huh.
Started learning homeopathy on informal basis through one World Teacher Trust in Vishakhapatnam earlier. Mm-hmm. 1 year I studied for my kids' sake. They are under treatment of homeopathy for since birth, basically. Mm-hmm. I was told by Dr. Rangarajan about this webinar, and I find it to be very interesting for a layman like me. I could get a lot of inputs from you and your colleagues there. I am really grateful to for this opportunity. I was just writing my impressions on the chat only. I did not expect to speak because there are many important doctors who have experience in this field.
Yeah,
so thank you so much, doctor.
Our pleasure. Yeah, take care.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay. Now I will just share, you know, just how I spend. Some of you know, but some of you don't know. See, basically, you know, my one leg is in India and one leg is abroad. Almost I visit 14 to 15 countries a year. Imagine a person like me to be locked down in the house where he's all the time working, all the time teaching, all the time with patients internationally. But I feel this is also the other side. The two side has to be balanced well. When you are professionally and personally, the right and the left, this is what I was doing since last 2 years. In fact, all the Himalayan walk which I did with my students, or the walk in the different part of India or abroad, the idea was to balance these two sides. And I told them that be a tourist in your own house, in your own place. This is where the success lies. Yeah. So what I do whole day is morning I get up. Yeah. And first I do a sunrise photograph because my window faces that, and daily a different photograph with a meaning which is in the present situation. I think it must be your. Yeah, for like this, you know, sun anchored. Daily a different object in a hook like this. If you see the another one, ignite your holistic center in a home alone space. Or like this, a sunrise and a sunset, you see, and then lost today somewhere between sunrise and sunset. Two golden hours, each set with a 60 diamond minute. No reward is offered, but they are gone forever. But I have glimpse of my inner being in this alone, blissful lock-up state. Yeah, and this picture came out a cloud like a form of a messiah or a prophet. It's just daily, same space, same time, same balcony, same photograph. But how you make it different, that I can go to abroad and have a best holidays or best places, but the same place, how you make it beautiful. Like Shailesh showed those micro photographs, the Weber showed what he is doing. Like each one of them, the same alone space, how beautifully you can change your direction and everything will change. It's like the another piece I found in my balcony, you only live once. And then it comes, you only live in such space. But if you live it right, once is enough to transform and heal at the whole level. Then another picture with a yoga pose was there, and I gave an energy of a female in front with a wire. And the quote comes like this, that when we are anchored, in a right sense, our intuitive right brain energy start driving our holistic car of a life to its highest purpose of existence, to heal self and help others to heal themselves. Or like, you know, this, that a dream catcher was there in my daughter's room. Every morning my mind goes, which photo? And it is 45 days. Daily I take three different photos and still it is going on. I locked myself up few days before all of you did. See, with this came, catch the individualistic and pandemic disturb energy. Catch the simulimum field, holistic healing energy. Unite both of them in a dream of you, the dream catcher means a homeopath or a healer or a you, a holistic pandemic healing will happen. It just create that intention, that simulimum field, that's it. People are just worrying, talking about those same news again and again. You can, and like this, I have now around 200 pictures. And daily morning, I'm selecting another one. Like this, a few days before. Make friendship with your alone, blissful home space. Together, you will create a simulimum space. The new whole higher purpose, much bigger, more integrative and holistic, will come up. It's like just a ring, but see the beauty. And then since the COVID, a different art space came up. Art with the, my father, he's a jewelry maker. So I took some wires with him and made this called symbiosis, that you and virus needs to be together. Just some gone crazy. Another artwork came up is this, which even Jeremy liked it and he spoke in his lecture. The fourth step, which I spoken in the beginning. Another artwork is like this. All this were lying there in my drawers. Idea is daily you bring out one and create something. Two bird, I put my daughter, you know, this plastic bird, put it there, but a different home. They stay in your alone space, but together. And together, the third ring, it will speak about new a pattern. It's all around you. This were broken things lying there. I'm just daily using it. This is, I call it, within the whole there is Trinity, and within the Trinity there is whole. Here for Trinity is our three-legged stool or our three principle, individualization, holism, and simulimum. Within that lies the whole. And within the whole lies this. And this was the pendant broken of my wife. She had given me, I said, I'll make something out of it a year back. And now I made it. Or like this, you know, which some of you have seen this, a wish fulfilling tree, Kalpvruksh, from the same copper wire. Put two copper wire snake, but took a plant form. And a broken kitchen of a Buddha, I put it there. It's just, and am I doing this only? No. So idea is daily like this, even a painting. This is like a, what you call the circle of life. And then the tree is coming out. So with a stone, with a wire, it's just daily, 1 hour in the morning, 1 hour in the evening. 9 to 5, I'm in fact working more than what I did earlier, because I'm seeing my patient online. I'm talking to my colleagues, patients, especially COVID all over the world, talking to one or two relatives, one or two friends, one or two patients, guiding them. It's more than normal, but still I get this space. This way it will keep you balanced. And some household world, I have a work I've been assigned to, I'm doing that like this. So it is very important. Imagine 9 to 5 you work, keep that routine, but at least morning, evening, keep the household work and keep that beautiful balance. Daily one artwork like this, how many you can create? All things are around you. It will keep you moving. It will give you and your patient. When I talk to my patient and they said, we made a one artwork, I said, look, I will send you 10. Some children, something touches them. And they say, this is exactly like me. Or some patients say, wow. And their whole life start. They said, we were looking at the negative energy. We should look at the positive energy. At the same time, I'm talking to my friends. Like today also, I spoke to the Tehran University, like which is AIMS of the Iran. And we were having a common lecture just soon with the help of WHO. All we're doing, but in between, this is also happening. This is where the exact, don't go to this news and what people are saying. Keep a balance, make a difference to one life. So one hour a day, do your creativity. One place which you like in your house, sit there, see what comes up. Read one book which you like and do routine work. This is where I feel it will make a huge difference. Even these two broken wood pieces, I put them together like this and called it touch of symbolism. It will all happen. And why? See, imagine I'm talking to WHO people also. I'm talking to a lot of homeopaths, a lot of people all over the world, from Jeremy to all those who are doing a beautiful work daily level, and on doing this photography and all. And my whole aim is my own people, close people, where if they can talk to their five patients, it makes a difference. That's why, look, the people who spoke to you, they could have easily gone into depression or the rat rut of what is going on around. But they are making that difference with one patient, one advice, one simulimum feel. I feel this way, beautiful thing can happen. Imagine 200 of you have remained now. If you talk to daily one patient, it's 200 life. And long term, 45 days, it's huge. And they will bless you that, doctor, you brought this creativity out. Doctor, you brought this thing out, which was all lying within me. At the same time, you explain them scientifically what is COVID. At the same time, you give them an advice what to read. At the same time, you say, whenever you are upset, my shoulder is there. Blast out in front of me. Rather than going on into what is happening around. I feel this is where together we need to create that environment. Internationally, I could tell all the artists to create a platform where you share your art. Why can't we? This energy will, we say this is a simulimum field we are creating. Let's create a pandemic. If a virus has created pandemic, let's create pandemic. From science to art to holistic advice. I am convinced, otherwise I wouldn't have spoken to you. I'm speaking, all of others are doing it for years, months together. I'm just speaking to you after understanding this. Any question, anyone? So I leave you with a healing hug with a touch of simulimum. That hug is alloyed. The more close the simulimum is locked with you, it is best. Yeah, if any question any one of you has, feel free to write to the team around or write to us and I will answer. I know many I could not answer. I will answer, put it on here and also put email to all your teachers who are, because of whom you are here. They are close to me and they will answer your most of the question. If not, I'm there. Okay, dear everyone. So we stop here. Any question here? Yeah, and I would really advise that all of you submit your artwork. Let's see what we can do about this, but I'm sure some of your artwork will be similar to someone. Your story, submit your story, record it or write it and submit to the teacher around you or to us. This example will help us to give to the patient where we can create the similar field. Yeah? Okay, so submit here or to your teacher. Take care. Bye-bye, everyone.